Darnell, it seemed like you were trying to get the crowd charged up all night, but it really seemed like after Walmart's touching Colby, everybody got into it, the crowd kind of came all at once. Did that get you guys going?
Yeah, it did, because it seemed like the refs were just against us tonight. And, you know, when we face adversity like that, I had to get my guys together and rally them up and tell them, you know, it's 8-5 right now. So we got to do whatever we got to do to get back in this game and try to get the win.
Have you guys, in a sense, been kind of waiting for Terrence to, you probably knew he had that in him, a performance like that?
Yeah. That's cute. Yeah, Terrence is capable of that. And, you know, any game it can happen. Some games you're going to have off nights. You know, he didn't even start off well, but all of a sudden he got going, and, you know, he's difficult to stop once he gets going. You know, whether you're guarding him close and everything, he's difficult to stop once he gets going.
Abdul, what adjustments did you guys make halftime to go against the 2-3 zone, and what were you doing that wasn't good in the first half?
We adjusted. We put Tony in the middle, and they put one guy in there to stay with him, so that opened it up more. Also, we knew we had to make shots to win this game. We were down, and we couldn't just rely on our defense. Like, our defense, we were guarding, and we were missing. And I was like, man, we're not going to win this game if we don't make shots. And I told Terrence, I said, from now on, we got to start making shots somehow. And he got going.
What was it about Tony being in the middle there that helped get things going for the offense? What opened up? What kind of shifted?
You put him in the middle, and one guy has to stay with him, because if he catches it in the middle, he's a problem driving to the basket. He got the free throw line so many times once we got it to him in the middle, and he's so aggressive. And it also got their bigs in foul trouble. You know, Modum and Lodowick, he attacking the basket. You know, so that opens it up, and then they don't want to be as physical anymore, things like that.
Tony, you were pretty beat up after the last game. How are you feeling right now?
Real sore, but, you know, we got the win, so, you know, that's just kind of outweighing my pain right now. You know, it doesn't really matter because, you know, like I said, we got the win, so I'm just, you know, enjoying this win and just going to keep rehabbing.
Tony, have you ever played in an atmosphere like that?
No, I never played an atmosphere like that. I played close, but especially when we start coming back and getting the league, it was loud and you couldn't even hear yourself. You couldn't talk to your teammates, so it was a crazy atmosphere. It just shows like what our crowd is capable of when we do great things. You know, so we just gotta keep moving forward and do good things so we can keep having a crowd like that.
Do you think it tangibly impacted your game or the game itself?
Yeah, it gets all of us going. You know, first starts with us when we start coming back, and then once we start, you know, playing defense, the crowd gets into it, and then that's how we start getting dunks and steals and layups. So, you know, crowd's a big factor. That's why, you know, it's hard to win on the road.
Darnell, what do you think you guys have learned about sticking it out when it's going so poorly early on and you're not out running and shots aren't going down and they continue to sag and it's just so clogged in there?
It's just all a matter of knowing what we're supposed to do defensively. You know, like Abdul said, you know, there's going to be times where our shots not falling. Like it was tonight, we were shooting 29% in the first half. We were hitting shots, we were guarding a little bit, but they were still up 6. You know, when we put the clamps on them in the second half, and then we started guarding more, and then we started getting layups and getting easier shots and knocking down shots. That made it a lot easier for it towards the end of the game.
Darnell, your 2 dunks, that just really seemed to get everybody going. Can you just walk us through what happened there?
When Tone got the steal, I was just thinking just run with him because he's such a great passer. You know, and I thought he was going to shoot it, so I was going to get the rebound, but he dropped it off to me, and I got the dunk. And then the second time, I guess we were it was the zone. They was running the zone, and nothing was between me and the rim, and I kind of made eye contact with Abdul, and he threw it up there, so I had to go get it.
Abdul, what's more impressive? You throw the lob to Terrence, and he kind of contorts himself and dunks it, or he takes the step back, kind of almost turn around for you. I mean, what is more impressive to you as a player?
He does those things. He's had multiple amazing plays this season that he can do those type of things. He's a freak athlete, so I'm not surprised that he does it. When he does do it, you know, it amazes us, and I mean, none of us feel like we have to crash the boards because we think he's gonna make it, for you know. So it's crazy to think like that, but that's how gifted he is.
Have any of you three ever seen someone dribble from off the block out to the line to take a step back?
Him.
We were on time. We've seen him do it. Yeah, he's been killing it in practice doing that. So
yeah,
like we weren't surprised that he did what he did today, because in practice he does it all the time. You know, he wasn't like we knew what he was capable of. So like, what he did with that, it was shocking to y'all, but in practice, he does that all the time. He just tortures, you know, the defender. So it just shows how capable, what he's capable of. And when he's playing like that, it's hard to stop him. And I just think all of us going because he's a great scorer.
So when you guard him, even if you have a hand up in his face, doesn't matter?
Yo, that's when he shoots better. He makes
a better
hand in his face.
Yeah, he has to have a hand in his face.
He won't hit wide open.
Yeah, when
he hit the one in the chest.
For you guys, it kind of looked like you guys were missing CJ for the first 30 minutes. Was that sort of the storyline a little bit? And then,
CJ, great player, and we definitely needed him, especially to knock down shots. But I really feel like in the first half, thing that we weren't doing a good enough job of was moving the ball. You know, we got caught standing, you know, and when Tone was playing the perimeter and they were just back off of him, and we didn't have anybody moving, so it just forced him to drive, and sometimes they call a foul, sometimes they won't. But in the second half when we adjust, it threw a different kind of look at him, and with him playing in the middle, it was more aggressive, and we had shooters spaced out. So it was easier for us in the second half.
Abdul, defensively, did you guys do anything different in that last 10 minutes? It looked like you guys got real tough on Reggie Moore and on Wroten, trying to take away that high screen and roll.
At the beginning of the second half, they started backdooring us a lot, and they were getting easy buckets. So we came together, and we were just like, man, we're not going to deny out so far because we know they're going to backdoor us, and then we're just going to guard them straight up because Reggie was trying to go one-on-one. Faisal Aiden was trying to go one-on-one, and we can guard those guys straight up, make them take tough shots if we get the rebound, and then we just have good offense. And then once we made our adjustment, you know, on the offensive end, it was like, all right, now we can make our comeback.
Darnell, you've been a part of a couple games here where the Cougs, you know, walked off, celebrating stuff. How important is it for you to your last time here against them to win?
That's what I've been thinking about all week. You know, I was ready for this game. This game was really circled on my calendar. You know, it's my last time playing the Cougars at home, and I definitely wanted to go out with a victory, and we did, and I'm glad my teammates rallied up with me so we can get it done.
What would you guys rate Lorenzo's tantrum that got the technical? Was it one of the better ones that you guys have seen?
The one West Virginia, when his jacket came off and he left it down his arm. That was a better one. That was funnier, but this one was kind of, it wasn't that fun.
Did that work? Did that affect you guys? I mean, you go, oh, okay, and then you wake up as a bad evening?
I mean, yeah. And then Darnell gathered us up and he was like, man, let's go. You know, we got to pick it up somehow. We had good leadership from our senior this year, this game. You know, he really picked us up. He had big shots and things like that. So he rallied us together and we just followed him.